Thank you. Imagine this. Imagine a future where everyday products come from locally available and renewable sources, where soil life is enhanced and desertification is prevented or even reversed. Imagine a future where transport takes place on eco-friendly roads that store carbon dioxide, where paper is produced without sacrificing trees or forest habitat against significantly lower emissions, where construction materials are bio-based and the chemical industry will become more and more sustainable. Imagine a future where we can suck carbon dioxide from the atmosphere so that we can grow one of the most sustainable crops in the world. I want to welcome you to that future. Welcome to the world of elephant's grass, our miracle crop. Sorry. Now, man's ingenuity brought us prosperity, our ability to solve complex problems and take use of whatever we have available in the vicinity has evolved beyond belief. Improved mobility gave us more freedom and the possibility to travel the world. Ever since the late 1800s, food, medicine, and all sorts of products enhance everyday life. And when the internet came, we were able to serve the world by the click of a button. And what we need can be found anywhere on the planet. Man's ingenuity brought us prosperity. And it got us into trouble too. The growth of population, our consuming behavior, and the dependence on fossil fuels and fossil resources have increased the atmospheric level of carbon dioxide, currently at a level of 415 parts per million, which means that we are on the way to a double amount of CO2 in the atmosphere compared to the natural situation. If we want to preserve whatever we have left and bring back the nature that we have lost so far, we need man's ingenuity once again. But the good news is, we can. But we have to start doing this yesterday. When I was working in the paper industry, as a chemical engineer, we were constantly searching for new, cleaner, and better raw materials. We looked at greenhouse residues, roadside grass, food waste, and we succeeded in making paper and board out of almost any fiber. But one particular alternative stood out. And it was the only one that was able to compete technically, economically, and I think most important, ecologically. Because we all know, in the world of big numbers, if one of these is not in line, you can just forget about it, because it's not going to happen. And here we have our sustainable champion, elephant's grass. And we succeeded in making a very good paper quality from this elephant's grass. And we were thrilled. We were excited. But we also immediately realized that if we wanted to make this innovation a real game changer, we had to do a better job. And to us, that means use every part of the plant. Now, Let's take a closer look at our champion. Elephant's grass is planted once and can be harvested every year for 25 years. It doesn't need any fertilizer, pesticides, nor herbicides, and it doesn't need a lot of water to grow. It actually enriches the soil with organic matter, improving soil life. And very important, it is not an invasive breed. So it's also a safe crop for biodiversity and indigenous vegetation. Also very importantly, it yields approximately 20 tons of dry biomass per hectare every year. And it can be harvested from the second year on. If we compare this to wood, this is 6.5 times more. And wood takes 25 years to grow. If you compare the surface area that you would need to grow forest or to grow elephant grass at the same biomass output, we only need 15%. 15% of the land use. And this land can be found in sandy soil, contaminated land, wasteland, or land that is currently being used for production of biomass. And here we have him, standing tall. Elephant grass can grow as high as 4 meters. When it's harvested, it's 90% dry. And this stem is almost completely composed out of CO2-based components. Now, we succeeded in making a very good paper quality out of this elephant's grass. 59% of all paper is based on trees, on wood. In huge pulp plants in Scandinavia and Brazil, tree logs form the basis of the process. And every component but cellulose pulp is dissolved using a chemical solution that also contains sulfur. The dissolved components are concentrated and burned, and the cellulose fibers are washed and dried. Did you know, as a small fact, that wood pulp and forestry actually emits 200 kilograms of carbon dioxide per ton of pulp even before a log arrives at the factory? Now, in our process, we extract every component selectively using a much milder process that is sulfur-free. And in this way, besides paper, we are able to produce construction materials, composites, cosmetics, flavors like natural vanilla, food, pharma, and chemicals. And we also came up with a way to use one of the parts, the plant's components, called lignin, in asphalt, or as we call it, grassfold. In this block, 50% of the bitumic binders are replaced by Mother Nature's natural binder, lignin, replacing a product that emits CO2 for a product that stores CO2. Now, in the Netherlands alone, the annual asphalt production is a mind-blowing 7 million tons. 7 million tons of asphalt every year. And these 7 million tons, they contain 500 to 600,000 tons of bitumic binders. 500 to 600,000 tons of oil refinery residue ending up in the tarmac and eventually in the atmosphere every year. Now imagine the amount of CO2 that can be prevented from emitting to the atmosphere and that actually can be stored. It could go into the hundreds of thousands of tons captured every year. Now, of course, we have tested it. We have tested it in the lab. And we have tested it in an industrial scale. And guess what? It works. We have used GrassVault already in several bicycle lanes, bus lanes, roundabouts, parking lots, city center infrastructure, and more. And wouldn't it be cool if we could use GrassVault here in the province of Utrecht for a project that is currently taking shape and is called the Bicycle Lane of the Future, or as we call it in Dutch, het fietspad van de toekomst. For many sustainability questions, elephant's grass can be an answer. And with our team of dedicated, brilliant, and young engineers, we prove that every day. The materials that could come from our crop are used in everyday life anywhere in the world. And elephant's grass grows anywhere too. And so we need to grow. We need to grow this crop. We need to grow capacity. We need to make paper, asphalt, construction, the chemical industry, sustainable and regenerative. So I call out for the industry, for the government, and for the people to decide what your future will look like. Because together, we can grow a future. Thank you.